There we go.
What's up, guys? It's Johnny Candido of Candido Training HQ. And as you can tell, I'm trying out some new powerlifting equipment here. I have my SPD knee sleeves on, which I've had before in the past, but I bought a new belt, a 13 millimeter belt, and SPD wrist wraps. And you see, I'm warming up with them just so I don't feel a little bit awkward once I throw it on later on. And here you see, I'm playing this in reverse so that you can tell I have a little bit too much of a quad dominant descent, because when I play in reverse, you can see it looks like I'm then sitting my hips back and rising up just straight up and down. So that shows me that in real time, what I need to do is sit back just a little bit more so that both of those match up and that they're consistent, both front ways and playing it in reverse. Anyways, I'm doing 500 pounds here. I have not handled this weight for reps in a long time. I think since my prep for Worlds. So four reps there, I'm very happy with that. And then afterwards, what I did is five singles with 490 pounds. One of the reasons why I got a 13 millimeter belt, which is thicker than the normal 10 millimeters, is so that hopefully once I find the right tightness and position, that then it can restrict essentially my mobility, forcing me to not squat too deep. And it's something that a lot of smaller lifters have a harder time catching a stretch reflex, unlike bigger lifters, because the bigger guys can kind of bounce off their guts a little bit. Now here what I'm doing is I was actually going to do some Olympic style squats, but then I remembered actually a Cody LaFever video, and I'll include a link in the description to his channel. He has a great channel. I really like his attitude and his vlogs, but he had a video doing this where you put your feet together and he called them plat squats. So here I want to test out what I could do on that. So I loaded up four plates here and I gave it a go, and this felt very strange. So I'm not going to say I recommend that you do this necessarily, but it was an interesting test for myself, and that felt, it was pretty easy, but it just felt very awkward. Now onto the benching. Once again, I'm trying out those SPD wrist wraps, and I got the stiff versions. You can get two. You can get either stiff or a slightly less stiff version. And I'll include a link in the description, once again, to Anderson Powerlifting, where I got all this. But anyways, the point was, what I want to say is that it felt very good on the back squats, and I've yet to really form an opinion on how it feels when benching. I just was not using wrist wraps at all leading up to this. I've tried Titan ones before, but then didn't really like them. So I'm going to give this a shot, and right now I don't have an opinion, but the benching actually felt very bad. And what it ended up being was that I just did not eat enough, because I didn't eat actually, it was I think 8 hours before this workout. So that's why I had to lower the weight for the last set. Okay, so the pause singles on the bench, the heavy pause singles, are not going to happen today because I just don't have enough energy and I'm feeling a little lightheaded. So I'm going to go to McDonald's, get something to eat, and then come back for the pause deadlifts. And this is a lesson I've learned with full body training. I need to bring a Gatorade or something with calories in it, not just drink water, because I just get too exhausted. I'll see you guys soon. All right, now I'm trying out those deadlift slippers, as you see, for these pause deadlifts. And I included that because I have to admit that deadlift slippers, in my opinion, look absolutely terrible. But obviously it doesn't matter. All that matters is that you're as low to the ground as possible under the rules that they enforce, and you're not allowed to use socks in competition. Now, I hit a huge PR by hitting 525 for three. The one thing I will say, though, is the pauses were a little too short for my liking. By the way, I'm using the 10 millimeter suede belt I bought for the deadlifts here rather than the 13 millimeters I use in the squats. And I have to say, this belt is very flimsy and I don't recommend it. I like the leather 10 millimeter better than this. You'll see I missed that last rep on that second set of 525 because my grip was just starting to give. And then on the third set, I just did one rep due to this. And I was planning on three sets of three, but I'm happy with this as that was a big PR regardless. And then afterwards, I hit my mandatory single of just 550 I set for myself. And it was slow, but that's to be expected because I was completely worn down at this point. Then for my optional accessories, I'm doing three sets of 20 on two exercises, single leg leg press and then rear delt fly. I have to admit it looked a bit awkward using the rear delt fly machine with my singlet on.
Let's hit up some rear delts to prevent muscular imbalances.
Biggie died, they shot a star. Who you know in West LA? Bring that ruckus to MA. Jeez.